Alrighty guys, what is up? Welcome back to Stoneblock 2 with Lone Debater 7, and today we're going to be taking a look at how to make water as well as getting clay. So this is pretty straightforward. To get clay, which is actually one of the next quests in the line, we need to get some dust and put that dust inside of a crucible that's full of water. The way you fill this guy up is by putting in trees, but what I would suggest with the first two blocks of water you get out of your crucible, actually don't use that to make clay. Actually use it to make an infinite water source. So if you remember from a couple episodes ago, we had those three iron ore chunks. I smelted them real quick and made a bucket. That is basically the best use for your first three iron, is to get a bucket. And the reason for that is, this is how you get water. You take any saplings, fill this guy up, it takes 10 of them, and that'll make us one bucket of water. But after you get a second bucket, you can make an infinite water source. So I'm just gonna go ahead, break this guy into the floor so it's a little bit cleaner. But if I put one there, and then once this guy is full, we'll get our second one. If I put it on this diagonal, we now have infinite water and we don't have to waste our saplings to make it. So that is pro tip right there for you. Don't use the first two blocks to make dust, just use them to make an infinite water source. It's going to be way worth your time because you won't have to wait for water to generate anymore. The other thing I did just want to show you guys on these silkworms. So if you get a bunch of these, you put them in the furnace and cook them, you get a cooked silkworm. It's only one lamb shank worth of food, I guess, but it is relatively renewable because if you crook your leaves off the tree, you'll get some silkworms over time, and just generating wood kind of does that. So while that's going, I did just want to talk about this. So as you can see, we've got four trees now placed, and the reason why I've got it set up like this is if we grow all four of them up, which normally the fourth one doesn't like to grow, but that's fine, good enough. We can actually ore excavate with the axe that we built and chop all the logs that are touching each other in one go. So it makes gathering wood a lot faster. You can always crook all the leaves if you really want. I'm not too worried about it at this point. We've got a lot of birch saplings, so it's fine. We'll crook some more when we need more food. But that's kind of a way to increase your wood production. You put as many saplings together as possible, grow all of them, and then you can ore excavate all the log blocks in one go, so makes it better. All right, we got our second water bucket, and now we've got an infinite source, so we don't have to wait for water to spawn anymore. It's always going to be available to us, so that is pretty nifty. Let's go ahead and make some clay. So I'm going to make maybe, that's 12... let's maybe do 18 blocks, I guess. Probably worthwhile. So you hammer gravel to get dirt, you take dirt, and if you hammer it, you get sand. And then once you hammer that sand, you will get the dust. That's kind of how this works. So you have to hammer quite a bit. Oh shit, I broke our... damn it, it's not what I wanted to do. I broke our dirt in our tree farm, so be careful with that. If you have blocks touching each other that are the same and you ore excavate, even if it's just catty corner, you may end up ore excavating those as well. So to get clay, you just click in your dust, pop it out. Now we've got a block of clay. So I'm just going to make a few. And this is why you want to make the infinite water source. If we had to wait for saplings to compress for all this water, it would take a really long time to make 22 blocks of clay. With this, it's pretty damn fast. You just have to switch between two items, set your hot bar up like mine, so they're next to each other and it goes really quickly, and you can get your clay made relatively fast. The reason why I'm doing this many blocks of clay is you not only need it to make like a crucible in order to unlock lava, but you also need it in order to make grout for the smeltery, which is how you upgrade your tools to metal. We'll do that later, obviously, because we also need sand and stuff like that. But now we've got 22 blocks of clay. That's pretty cool. So yeah, that's how you make water and how I would suggest doing it. Like, get enough iron to build a bucket and kind of go that way. A little trick for you, if you don't end up getting the iron you need to make a bucket, if you make one block of clay, you can actually make what's called a clay bucket with three of them. So if you put three clay like a bucket, it'll give you one of these unfired clay buckets. You pass it through a furnace, and then you can pull water out. So at maximum, you only have to make three in order to get an infinite source. At minimum, you only need to do two if you already could make a bucket. So it just kind of depends on how you do stuff. So just wanted to show that off for you, because it can be kind of tedious waiting for the saplings to compress down into water. So that's how you kind of avoid it. You just do the first two, then you can build an infinite water source. So before we end the episode, I want to go through and gather up these quests. So got a couple from last time, and then the one for the clay. So we got an entity detector, we got a conversion kit, and we got another star crux. Okay, so next one in line is to build a crucible. To do this, we need porcelain clay, which requires bone meal and clay. To get bone meal, you have to sieve dirt, I think, or dust. You sieve dust. If you do it through a flint mesh, you got a 15%. If you only have string, it's only a 10. So I'd suggest, you know, sieve some gravel first so you can, you know, get the higher drop chance. It's probably gonna take about a stack worth of dust to get the bone meal that you're gonna need to make your crucible. So I would suggest just pushing through a full stack. It doesn't necessarily hurt you either, because you can get other drops that are beneficial from sieving, you know, just dust. So it's not gonna hurt you to sieve a little extra. We'll build another stone hammer. Keep that on me. Finish doing this. Whoops. Push the wrong key. There we go. Okay, now I need to be careful of that dirt, so we're gonna just build up on this wall instead. This tree's kind of in the way, but it doesn't really matter. As long as these blocks are touching, or excavate will work just fine. So they don't have to necessarily be in like a massive brick, but they do need to be touching, so just bear that in mind. Alright. Cool. Go ahead, get the sand broken down, and we might be able to sieve enough dust and get the bone meal we need to make our crucible. It works basically the same, like, when you make your porcelain clay into the crucible, it'll be unfired, so you have to pass it through a furnace in order to get the usable version of the item, and then that is actually how you generate lava. So depending on where this goes, and if we get enough bone meal from this, like, 40 blocks of dust, we might be able to show that off as well. And once you have lava and water, you can make a cobblestone gen. We only got one bone meal out of that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and sieve, or get more dust and sieve until we get enough bone meal. And then we'll pick up next time and kind of show off the crucible that you're gonna generate. So we'll do that next time, not a big deal. But anyway, guys, so today we covered how to get water, how to get clay, how to sieve to get bone meal, and some little life hacks on how to gather wood faster. So if you enjoyed the content, be sure to like, comment, subscribe as always. And until next time, this has been Lone Debater 7, and we will see ya.